Hello, my name is Nurse Pauline RN. Welcome to my channel. My goal is to assist nursing students to be successful in their fundamentals of nursing exam. The topic today is on urinary elimination. Physical examination of the renal system is done by inspection and palpation. When the bladder is going to be examined, do not ask the patient to void urine before. Palpation should be done with a full bladder. Examination of the urinary system and when patient is going to the bathroom or being placed on the bedpan, we should provide privacy. Close the doors. Use your drape and drape the patients well. Pull your screens. Provide privacy. Consider culture. Normal urine is yellow, pale yellow. Orange urine, assess if the patient is on peridium. This is a medication that makes urine orange. Hematuria is blood in urine. Proteinuria is protein in urine. Amber urine, assess if the patient is NPO, if the patient has decreased fluid intake. Patients may be on, some patients are on fluid restriction. Specific gravity is specific gravity is 1.005 to 1.030. Specific gravity measures the range of urinary concentration. Maybe patients, if the urines are concentrated, patients may be dehydrated. Patients may have excessive sweating. Patients may have diarrhea. Those are some of the things that contributes towards concentrated urine. Patients who are complete bed rest should not get up to go to the bathroom to void. They should not get up on the bedside commode. Complete bed rest means the patient uses the bedpan surgery. Patients who have urinary tract infection, assess for foul-smelling urine, dark foul-smelling urine. Patients' urine may be milky. Patients may have crystals in their urine. They may have white blood cells in their urine. They may have mucus in their urine. BUN and creatinine is an indicator of kidney function. GFR is your glomerular filtration rate. This measures your kidney function. This is done, your GFR test is a blood test. Estimates how much blood passes through the filters each minute. Filters called glomeruli. The nephron is the basic structure and functional unit of the kidney. When measuring urine, we use a graduate container. We should use this graduate at eye level for measuring accurately. 24-hour urine collection provides accurate excretion of creatinine protein chemicals released in 24 hours. Patients who are having 24-hour urine, the urine should be kept on ice for 24 hours. Keep changing your containers. Make sure they are on ice. 24-hour urine specimen early in the morning. If it's ordered, patient has to void the first urine you will discard. We will start our 24 hours urine on the second void. A calibrated container in the form of a hat is also used to measure urine output. A normal voiding is 30 cc an hour. If patient is not voiding 30 cc's an hour, notify the doctor. We should encourage our patients to have 2 to 3 liters of fluid a day. In order to encourage voiding, we should ambulate our patients. Ask them to ambulate the hallway or the room. We can use running bathroom while they are using the bathroom. We can pour warm water over their hands and fingers in order to assist them with urine. We should assess for abdominal distension. Patient should void 8 hours after Foley catheter is discontinued. If patient do not void, notify the doctor. When you insert a Foley catheter, or when you discontinue a Foley catheter, always document the time, the date you inserted or discontinue your catheter. Document the characteristics of your urine, the odor, the color, and you have to document the correct amount of output. The doctors are somewhere looking in the computer to see what their patients' outputs are throughout the shift. Abnormal urine is glossuria, pyuria, crystal urea, bacterial urea, hematuria, protein urea. Assisting patient to the bathroom, we have to exercise safety. Avoid using slippers. Take the throw rugs out of the way. Adequate lighting. Use ambulatory devices, walker, canes. Use grab rails while they're in the bathrooms. Use raised toilet seats. Use bedside commodes. Prevent falls. For bladder retraining, we'll try our best for every 2 hours. Bladder retraining is scheduling toileting for patients. Benefits by improving voluntary control over urination. Urinalysis is done to detect WBCs or red blood cells, stones, or sexually transmitted diseases. Those we will get from our urinalysis. Doctor will order culture and sensitivity. That's your CNS urine. It should be collected in a sterile container, closed container. This is a midstream urine collection, your CNS. Ask the patients to void, discard, and continue voiding into this sterile container. Remind your patients to clean from back to front. For uncircumcised males, retract their skin when administering perennial care. Flagyl IV or oral flagyl while the patients go home. We'll give them a prescription. For patients with urinary tract infection, Cauti, C-A-U-T-I. This is a catheter-associated urinary tract infection. It is a nasochromal infection caused by improper hand washing, caused by nurses or doctors not using enough sterile protection. Sterile procedure is broken while inserting the Foley catheter. Catheter-associated urinary tract infection is caused by an E. coli bacteria. Patients who are using external condom catheter. The sizes are small, medium, large, and extra large. Make sure you are using the correct sizes on your patients, which means you would have to know the size before you bring them in, or you can bring a variety of sizes. We are preventing irritation of the skin, excoriation of the skin. For perennial care with patients with external catheters, we'll provide perennial care, especially after defecating. Avoid kinking the tubes for patients with external condom catheter. Remember to use your stat locks to assist us with prevention of kinking. To prevent excoriation, when you're gonna give the patient the external condom catheter, dry well. Incorrect size of external condom catheter causes restriction of the blood vessels. Avoid tapes. Avoid kinking your tubes. External condom catheter prevents infections. Indwelling Foley catheters, patients are at risk for urinary tract infections. Indwelling catheter inserted sterile procedure is used to accurately measure urine output. If you are unable to insert a Foley catheter, ask for help. If you insert a Foley catheter in the vagina, leave the catheter in. Go and get a new Foley catheter. With sterile techniques, with a second nurse, insert with sterile techniques the second Foley above the first Foley catheter into the urethra. Insert 10 cc's of sterile water to secure the catheter. Use your stop lock to secure your catheter. Prevent kinking, and then you take out your first catheter from the vagina. If you have a patient who, if you're inserting a Foley catheter into a male patient and you're unable to do so, you're meeting resistance, don't forget to ask the patient. Sometimes they forget to tell us when they come in that they did have a history of enlarged prostate or prostate surgeries. Just ask the patients, have you ever had a history of enlarged prostate or prostate surgery? 9 out of 10 times, they will tell you yes. Stop what you're doing, take the catheter out, notify the doctor. The doctor will be happy to come and put that catheter in for you. Foley catheter. Folic catheter must not be placed above the bladder. When patients are in a wheelchair or if patients are on a stretcher, place the Folic catheter below the bladder. When patients are in bed, do not place the Folic catheter on the rail of the bed. Place the Folic catheter on the frame of the bed. This is always a test question. Folic catheter irrigation is to keep the catheter free of mucus and blood clots. Maintain closed system of your catheter.